right now. We're looking at protests there that spreads across different parts of the country. Chandigarh is the latest. Doctors continue their fight for justice. Doctors protesting at Delhi's Connaught Place as well, where we're looking at many coming out on the streets holding a candlelight march. This is in Chandigarh. If I could take you through the images coming in from Chandigarh, particularly showing the doctors' community coming out in a candlelit march. Medicos demanding justice for the Kolkata rape victim and, of course, a complete overhaul of the laws that govern their protection. We're looking at Chandigarh images where doctors have come out on the streets with a candle as a candlelit march that they carry out demanding expedited investigation in the case of the Kolkata trainee doctor.
और क्या हाल होने वाला है अगर आप आज नहीं उठे थे, क्योंकि आज नहीं तो कभी नहीं।
Our correspondent reporter Aseem Basi joining us for more on that. Aseem, go on, give us more on the doctors who are out on the streets in a candlelit march in Chandigarh as well. What are their demands?
As the Calcutta incident has shook the entire nation, the protests in Chandigarh have been continuing past many days. But today, the doctors, the faculty is taking out a candle march. We'll talk to the doctors here. We have Mr. Dr. Dheeraj Kumar, who is the head of the faculty association. Sir, today you're holding a candlelight march, and what is the message you want to give through this candle march, protest candle march?
So with this candle march, we want to awaken every citizen of our country to the criminal act which happened, the most disgraceful act that we can think of, which happened at Calcutta at the RG Carr Hospital. And till date, we have not received justice. In terms, there is no trace of the perpetrator of the crime. The criminal who carried out this activity should be arrested, should be taken to task and given the most severe punishment that can be given to him. And we also want everyone to know that we should move towards having a more secure workplace in the clinical establishment by getting the CPA Act, which needs to be worked on by the government. The CPA Act is needed by us. This is our main demand. The CPA Act has to be.
We can hear clearly that they are not happy with the kind they want, that the justice should be delivered in that case, and also the security and safety of the doctors, the medical fraternity must be ensured, and they are pressing for CPA. And you can see the visuals clearly that hundreds of faculty members are moving inside the complex, the PGI, and holding this protest march demanding justice for them. We have some. Can I have a name, ma'am?
Dr. Shalini.
Dr. Shalini, today you lot of since past many days the strike is on in PGI, but today you people are holding a candle protest candle march. What is the basic idea and the message you want to give?
See, we are faculty. We are all joining the residents today. Today is a non-working day, so we have all come home from our homes, and we finished our ward works. And join the candle march. So the demands are very clear. We want justice for the person who has lost her life. This gruesome crime has to be answered. Where is the government? We don't know. And we also want the protection for the doctors, which is, you know, every day you hear an attack on the doctors. So this form of attack we were never expecting. And in a city like Calcutta, which is a populated city, it is not in the suburbs, such a crime, it makes the workplace very unsafe for the women. So this is the main problem.
You can see the women's safety.
All right. Thanks very much. I'm going to quickly cut across to Shilpa Nair, also in Tamil Nadu protests. Anmol Bali in Delhi, who is bringing us images coming in from the national capital. Anmol Bali, over to you first. Give us more. What are the scenes as doctors come out to protest today?
Nabila, as you can see in the visuals, currently I am here at the Connaught Place, which is also called the heart of the national capital, where you can see thousands of doctors, resident doctors from the various RDA have gathered here to protest and demand justice for the Kolkata hospital victim. And as you can see, they are holding placards and candles in their hand, and they are having a candle march, and they are protesting, and they are clearly demanding a Central Protection Act. I'll talk with some of the doctors to know what are their main demands. So, आपकी बड़ी डिमांड क्या है?
सर, सबसे पहले तो हमारी सेंट्रल प्रोटेक्शन एक्ट हमारी सबसे बड़ी डिमांड है, लेकिन आपने हमारे से मिनिस्टर साहब ने मीटिंग की थी, उन्होंने हमने बोले कि एक्ट आने में बहुत टाइम लगेगा, बट हमने ऑर्डिनेंस की मांग की है, लेकिन अभी तक हमारे को लिखित में कोई भी उन्होंने ट्रस्ट दिया नहीं है कि लिखित में कुछ ऐसा ऑर्डिनेंस आएगा, तो हम यही चाहते हैं कि अभी अगर ऑर्डिनेंस आता है तो हमें लिखित में दिया जाए।
ये भी देखा गया कि जो जांच थी वो सीबीआई को दे दी गई कलकत्ता हाई कोर्ट के द्वारा, और उसके बाद आज सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने बोला है वो सीयू मोटो इस मामले को परसों सुनेगा, तो इनको आप चीजों
ये सर बहुत बड़ी राहत है डॉक्टर्स के लिए कि सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने सीयू मोटो दिया अभी, तो हम ट्यूजडे तक का वेट करेंगे कि हमारे सीजे साहब हैं जल्दी से जल्दी इस केस को फास्ट ट्रैक में डालें और इसको जल्दी से हमें जस्टिस मिले सर।
You are a woman and you are also a doctor. What are the main difficulties which you see on the ground and why you need a Central Protection Act for which you are here and you are demanding and you are protesting?
What we are demanding are very basic needs. As a female, I am there on duty in the hospitals day and night. So especially in the night hours, we don't have any security guards, we don't have any CCTV cameras. We don't have any proper restrooms for females in the hospital setup. So it has been so long we are fighting for this, but the incident which has happened, the heinous crime which has happened, has shattered us all as a female doctor in India. So we want Central Protection Act to be implemented, start nationwide. We want the criminals to be caught. We want them to be hanged. We want the Supreme Court of India to take the immediate decisions over the case. This is all what we are demanding are very basic. This time it's a doctor. Next time it can be any female. We don't want it to happen with any female of the nation. We want our females, our sisters, our daughters to feel safe in our country. Today, as a female, feel very unsafe in this nation.
It was also seen that government has said that hospital head have to file an FIR after the incident with the doctor. How you look at it? Is it enough?
No. It's not enough. It's not enough at all. We need some emergency protection services to be there. We need ki something should be there which alarms the authority at start whenever the incident happens. We want such kind of security all over the hospital campus that whenever someone tries to assault or someone tries to misbehave, there is a strict action like within minutes. 6 hours is a very big limit. We want it to happen. We want the security to come, start and protect.
As you can see in the visual, doctors are holding candles and placards in their hand, and as you can also see, Delhi police is also deployed here in the heavy number because they are also here taking care of the traffic, because this is Connaught Place, which is the main point of the national capital. But doctors have clearly said that they won't budge, and in future they will take their protest to the homes of the politicians, member parliament, and they will demand the Central Protection Act. Like the same they are doing, earlier it was seen that they were protesting inside the hospitals, but now they are outside on the roads, and soon they will move towards the politician with their demands. Nilina.
All right, thanks very much for joining us.